Well, good morning, guys. Thank each and every one of y'all for clicking on the video. Well, good morning, guys. Welcome back to the channel. Thank each and every one of y'all for clicking on the video. Well, today we're going to finish the project from yesterday. So we've got to get finished this electric fence. We had some obligations yesterday to go to, so we went and had some fun. And what are we going to do this morning, Kayson?
Feed the chicken and look at the goats.
Feed some chickens and look at the goats. And what's that deal there?
My trap.
That's a trap. We'll talk about that a little bit later. That's all he's been talking about this morning. So we're going to get chickens fed, and then we're going to go check on the baby goats. And this video may be a part of the yesterday's video, but we'll just wait and see. But anyways, so we're going to do all
and
that.
We need to put the goats back up because they're not eating my bait.
They're eating your bait. I told him after today that goats, we're going to leave all the goats locked up. We're going to go through and put our electric wire up. We're going to put our dogs in. So we're going to do all that real quick, and then we're going to go check on the babies, the triplets. We got triplets, guys. They're absolutely beautiful. We're going to show y'all. I'm looking at them right now, and they are gorgeous. But give you a sneak peek, and then we're going to feed, and then we'll go over there and look at them up close and personal.
Yeah, I try to get them feed. I'm eating.
Yeah, try to get them eating. All right, let's go feed.
The hoe up there for Cowboy.
Okay, let's go up there and feed Cowboy then.
Yeah, there's a little hole somewhere. Here.
I guess we're going to feed Cowboy first. All right, you going to put him a little bit of feed in there?
Yeah, that looks like his bow.
That looks like his bow? All right, that should be enough. Let's go over here and feed the rest.
Let's dump some out here cause for the rest. Yeah. For the other ones.
We'll do that here in just a minute.
Yeah, that'll be the last.
And Steph, we had to take, or Stephanie had to take, let's start over here, bub. Stephanie had to take Leighton to the ER this morning. He's not feeling good still. So definitely keep him in the prayers. We're waiting to hear back from that. So
I'll do this later. Like, there it is.
Go ahead. There you go. Here, let Daddy give him another scoop. We won't give him, Daddy give him a big handful. Just like that right there.
Yeah.
Because there's four of them in that. Now, we're going to be getting rid of these, ain't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to be getting rid of these black silkies. So.
And then don't lay eggs.
Yeah, they don't lay eggs. If you don't lay eggs here on the farm, Kayson said.
They don't lay eggs.
So they got to go bye-bye. All right, let's go to the next one here.
These are brand new ones.
Yeah, these brand new ones. We'll show them. These are Kayson's chocolates.
Yeah, we got the one over here.
Yeah. You can go ahead and feed them, Bubba.
And then we check the egg last.
Yeah, we'll check the eggs. We'll check the eggs in the evening time.
Yeah. I got a handful this time. Yeah, enough, right?
Yeah, you're doing good. Here, Daddy's going to put you a little door up here so you can put your hand in.
Yeah.
That way, because... Which it's okay if it comes out here because there's chickens that run. But we just want to always give them a little bit extra. If they have some left over, that's fine. They can eat on it through the day, okay?
Yeah.
Let's move on to the next one.
They look like he ain't no more because he had a lot.
Yeah. There's Cowboy. Cowboy's checking everything out.
Cowboy.
Yeah. It looks like they don't like eating that corn, Bubba. Go ahead and give them some more. Look like they don't like eating the corn there. Good job. You're doing
good
job.
I'll do this way, like rub it.
Yeah.
Want me to give them one more?
Yeah, I'll give them another one.
This one.
Good job. All right, they got some food. We'll move on to the next one now.
This one, back here.
Yeah, and these are the babies and the Jubilees.
Yeah, these are my favorite ones.
Yeah.
I like the babies.
Yeah, you like them baby chicks, don't you?
So I like to catch them. They easily catch them out here because we need to put them up sometimes.
Yeah.
Because, one more scoop.
Because that's what them predators are eating, ain't it?
Yeah.
Here, Daddy's going to put a little bit more up here just because there's so many of them there.
Yeah.
You're doing a good job, though. But I think there's 10 baby chicks and 2 adults, so we're going to make sure we give them enough to get by with, okay? There's nothing wrong with them having a little bit of extra. Just like that.
Oh, then we eat all that?
Oh, yeah. If they don't eat it all, they eat it as a snack throughout the day. Do you like eating snacks?
Yeah.
All right.
I'm gonna get some right here, cut him like there.
Okay, yeah, you can give him a scoop. Good job. All right, look at these guys. These splashes are beautiful.
Yeah, because them like, this is where them eat, right here.
Okay, well just go ahead and throw it in there. Them splashes are beautiful, guys. Oh, no, let's throw it out here so they don't have to get over there in that corner.
That's where I see them.
All right, well, let's do it over here so they have some more room.
I got dog food in here.
That's fine. Just throw it in there. There you go. Get them big old scoops. That way they're...
One more.
Yeah, now maybe one more. Maybe one more.
Probably not all of it, but get a little bit in here.
Yeah.
And then I can pick the bucket up, just hit the fence.
Yeah, go ahead and throw them one more. Yeah, we can do that. That might be too much. Just go ahead and throw that scoop in there. Yeah, we don't want to throw the whole bucket in there. All right, let's go on to the next ones.
And the last one.
All right, so the last ones are over here.
Dad, look.
Yeah.
I think he's already done with his.
No, he's got some over there. Harry's over there running now. So let's go over here and feed these last ones and go check on the baby chicks, and then we got to get back to work.
Yeah.
Good job. Good job. All right, that's enough for them.
One more.
All right, that'll work. I do want to see if there's any eggs in here. We got a snake that's getting them, I think. Nope. They're lined up over there. Are you lining them up over there like that?
Yeah, see how many we have.
Oh,
that's
okay.
Why.
Okay. All right, we're going to gather them and get ready to put them in the incubator.
Yes, sir.
So what he does is I think he's getting all the eggs from the other pens.
Huh? Missing one more chicks.
Who?
Sabaside.
Sabaside's over here.
Oh, we need to dump.
All right.
We need to dump a little bit more for them because I made a dot.
Okay.
2 dots.
He made 2 dots, so he's got to make a little bit more. Guys, thank y'all so much for watching. I hope y'all enjoy this.
Don't step on it.
I just really enjoy waking up in the morning now and going out, especially with summer with the kids, just enjoying their time. You putting it out there?
Yeah, I got some over there.
You all right, sister? All right, let's go over here and check on the baby goats. All right, we're going over here to check on the baby goats now.
Here y'all.
And I think, hey, son, we're going to let out all the goats for right now since we're going to be working on the fence, okay?
Yeah, I want to let them out.
You want to let them out? All right, well, come on up here. We're going to let them out since we're going to be working on the fence today, let them go run and eat.
I tried to tie it a little bit. I know how to do it.
Right here, it's here at the top here.
I tied this thing.
Here, let me get down this knot.
I know how to do the knots.
Yeah, all right, now you can pull it. Ready?
Yeah.
And he's letting the gate out, boys and girls. Come on, girls. Y'all want to go out? Come on. Well, come on. Yeah, here we go. And we're off to the races. Well, come on, girls.
I'm going to get ready. Oh, I'm about to get ready.
Yeah. All right.
So,
the rest of them will go out on their own. Let's go over here and check. Oh, there's the 3 babies. Where's Mama?
She over there.
She's over there?
Yeah.
I'm gonna get her.
I let Cry Baby in here.
Yeah, I gotta get her another scoop. Oh, they got she's got little poo, yellow poo on her. Oh, did you put Cry Baby over here too?
Yeah.
Okay.
Make them friendly.
All right, guys, like I said earlier, we'll come back over after a while and check on the babies. I don't know why they're clogged up like that. I'll probably talk to, call Kevin or talk to Marie, one of the two, and make sure everything's all right. But from what I looked up, everything looks good, but it never hurts to ask somebody. So we're going to go ahead and start working on the fence. Steph did call just a few minutes ago. They are on their way home. They did finally get an IV in Leighton. They was having a hard time getting an IV in him. So I think Steph said they tried one arm, they couldn't, so they had to go to another. If they couldn't get in that, they'd have to go on the leg or something. But so he's severely dehydrated. And I'll let Steph kind of fill in everything, but I know it ain't nothing major wrong. I don't know if it's a bug or something, but we'll wait until Steph gets here and she'll tell us the whole story. Basically, we run our water from over there to all the way to the garden. So here in the near future, I am going to run a main water line from the tiny cabin all the way up to the garden. So we have a hydrant there so we can turn it off and on there, which that's on a list to do later on. After we get done with this fence, I'm going back to the tiny cabin. We are going to get started on that. I gotta finish it. I've got most of the materials now, and we'll use whatever we have to, we'll complete everything with the materials we have. And then the next month we'll go in to buy some more materials. We've already got the flooring picked out and the cabinets. So it's just going to take a little bit, but we're going to get there. I know there's a bunch of y'all that want to see the tiny cabin process. And honestly, we haven't got to do much. So once we, this week, we should get started back. So I'm going to go ahead and put a quick connect on this one. These quick connects make it pretty easy to, because we have to disconnect them because we drive through here. We'll hook them together. I'm going to go turn it on real quick and we'll see if it's leaking. All right, guys, we are headed to the top. I'm telling you what, man, this grass is unreal. We just mowed all this up here the other day and we got to go back again, which the goats are up there having fun now. Well, the corn and stuff looks really good, but we definitely don't want the goats to get down here. The goats to get down here and get a taste of the corn and stuff. But the corn we transplanted looks okay a little. It's taking, it looks like. I know Steph wants to mound her potatoes up. Maybe we can get to it today as well. There's just so much, guys. I never suspected it was this hard to maintain animals and land, you know, to do it right and keep it maintained good. We got rain yesterday and the day before yesterday. I didn't get water on them, so I should have got up here earlier this morning. It'd have been a lot cooler, but really it ain't that hot today. I forget what they call that netting stuff, or that hose stuff. Maybe it's just a soaker, but I can remember working at a nursery when I was younger, and there would be a hose that would go by, and each little plant had a little nozzle that went off of it. That's what I'm going to try to find. If y'all know what I'm talking about there, if you would, drop the name of it down in the comment box. I may already find out, but I know I definitely need to try to figure out and get one of those up here. So, because time is really, really valuable out here on the farm as I'm learning. And if I can come and just turn on a switch and just come out and make sure they're all good and walk away and then come back, that'd be great. But sometimes in the evening time, me and Steph really enjoys coming out here and just enjoying ourselves and watering and talking and visiting about the day. All right, guys, now that we got that done, I'm going to go down here, turn the water off, and attempt to get back to building the fence. I've only started this probably about two hours ago, and I still haven't got to get where the fence is. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull up here and disconnect this real quick. That way it don't get ran over. Let's see if we can get this dude apart. And we did. All right, guys, so I've got all the fence posts turned around. I did all that without recording and stuff, so got way back in there. So now we're going to put up the actual wire. And, boy, howdy, Kayson's getting it all set up again, ain't he? Have any luck over there yet?
Nothing.
Nothing yet? Uh-uh. Okay.
I'm trying to get Cowboy away. I'm trying to sneak in my stuff.
He's trying to sneak in your, and get your bait, huh?
Yeah.
All right. Well, hey.
I'll probably catch a chicken hawk.
Yeah, you might catch that chicken hawk. You never know.
I got chicken feet out here.
Yep, yep. Very well could. If you catch something, holler at me. I'm going to be back here building fence, okay?
Or you won't probably hear me.
Yeah, I'll probably hear you, won't I?
I don't know, because how loud is that chainsaw?
I ain't going to be using the chainsaw. I'm going to be building fence. Just holler at me. So here's the deal with the barbed wire. I'm probably doing this just completely backwards from what a lot of people will do, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to put one hot wire, barbed wire, and then another hot wire on top. Here's the reason why I'm going to leave the barbed wire up there is I've already had it up there and I don't want to take it out and roll it up. I can just leave it there until we get ready to move it or whatever, and I can move it to another location. It's just hard to wrap back up once it's unrolled. So I'm going to go ahead and leave it there. And that's the plan. We're planning on having this all electrified today. But I come through here and cleaned out this path all the way back there. But we're getting ready to go back there and put up the fence. And I'll kind of show you when we get back there. Oh, okay. All right. That boy, he got to love his imagination, though. Got to love his imagination. I'm so impressed what the farm has done with Kayson. He just absolutely loves it, guys. Thank y'all so much for y'all's kind comments and, you know, he can't read yet, but we do read him the comments, and he gets a kick out of them, so. Trying to get a little bit more so he can stack it up. All right, I got all my materials now, get my gloves on, and we're going to go back here and stretch this fence again. So like I say, guys, this fence isn't permanent, so. You know, I don't have any corner post or any H braces or anything like that. I just try to tighten it up as best as I can, and then we'll come back and put the electric wire up. Going back through here, I think that's all pretty good right there. I can put one on bottom, one on top. So we'll continue with that path. That way. Okay, guys, so we've made it over here to the pond now. I went ahead and stretched the wire, undone all of it all the way around. So now I'm going to go through and put the ties on it, and then once we complete that, we'll go over and we'll start putting the electric fence up, and we should be good to go. It's definitely taking a lot longer than what I expected, but that's everything. Hey, Carly girl, what you doing? What you doing, little Carly girl? What you doing? Yeah. Isn't that a tick? Yeah, we definitely got to get something for some ticks for them because, I don't know. Just, we've been pulling off a couple ticks here and there. That stuff we gave them was supposed to take care of it. We put a drop behind their head, but it didn't. But she's a good livestock guardian dog, and you can't be jumping up here like this. You're going to get me in trouble and yourself in trouble. So, anyways, hey, down. I love you, but I'm telling you, girl, you're going to get us both in trouble. You know what? I love you to death, but you're going to get us both in trouble. You're a good girl, though. You're a good girl. How's your... This is her hurt foot here, in which you can see that we've already cut, you know, trim them back, and it just does not help, does it, girl? Does it? It might help a little bit. Yeah. You're a good girl, though. Carly girl's a good livestock guardian dog. Yes, she is. Yes, she is. Dixie got to come over and get her some lovin's, too. Dixie got to come over and get her some lovin's, too. Yeah. Yeah. No, we don't jump now. We don't jump. I got to get back to work, so I'm going to put this over here and I'll show a few and then probably show the rest at the end. What are you doing, Badger? Huh? What are you doing? Oh, you think this is a food bowl? You think it's a food bowl? Y'all ain't getting no food right now. All right, Kayson said he caught something. We gotta go, Kayson said he caught something over here. What'd you catch?
Somehow a big chicken stepped on there and I wasn't looking and something I couldn't see because I went inside and something I caught something.
Oh really, what is it?
Yes.
I don't know. Well, show me. A chicken?
Yeah, a big chicken knocked that over.
Oh, what you got under there? Let's see what you got. Oh, you caught a baby chick.
Somehow, he got out.
Oh, my goodness. How'd he get out?
Mm-hmm.
Well, the whole deal... We should have caught him. Got to get him back in the pen. Well, at least he caught something in his trap. Well, good job. That hard work
paid. No, I didn't do it. I didn't did it. I didn't pull the rope.
Oh, a chicken did.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. That sounds like a big old chicken story to me.
Yeah.
Huh?
That would be that black one and rooster and subside.
Oh, my goodness. You better reset that.
I did.
Okay. He wants to catch something so bad, but here's the deal. When I was a kid, I had imagination too, so I think it's awesome. It's awesome. All right, guys, that is the fence. We got all of that up. Now we are going to go back over. So now we're going to go back over here and get a side-by-side, and we're going to start the electric line over here in this corner. And then we're going to bring it all the way back over here to the end of the property over there on the south side. But before we do all that, look at him. Look at that boy. He will live out here with these animals. That boy will stay out here with these animals, that's for sure. But anyways, want to get subside, get something to drink, and we'll get started. All right, like I said earlier, guys, in the last video, I think we ended up getting 100 of these. So two of them's got to go in each pole. So we might as well go ahead and take a couple bags with us. That's for the ground wire. We'll take three bags with this, see if that'll get us through. I think I got it figured out here. It wasn't too hard, really. I messed around with it a little bit the other day to try to figure it out and make sure I got everything right. So I'm going two from the top here. So there's one, two. So I'm going to put it right chill. All right, guys, I had to come back over here to the side-by-side, and we are going back over there where I stopped. I've got one more pack of those little clips, and I can already tell you right now, we don't have enough, so we're going to have to go back to town and get some more. Honestly, when I bought them, I thought 100 of them would have been leftovers, but I used more hose than what I expected. Yeah, a lot more close than what I expected. Kayson's got all the goats pinned up, but a few of them. He rounded all of them up, but one or two. They're in there just waiting to eat. But this is where we stopped right here, but I know we're gonna have to get more. Got one roll of this, this electric fence wire. What we're using is all American Farm Works products, which we get most of all of our stuff at Tractor Supply, but you can order it offline. We'll leave a link in the description box. That's the only thing that we've used out here on the farm, because that's the only thing closest to us. There is things I like about it, and there's things I don't like about it, especially with the electric fence, the charger part, but just for now, that's what we're going to use to get by. It's local. Like I told Stephanie when we started this in here, I told her that, you know, it's probably going to cost us a little bit of money, but I want to do it right. So now we're doing the outside. This is where they've been getting out. Over here on the backside, we will probably have to run some on the backside, because the goats will probably end up start trying to climb it. But that's going to be a pretty good chore. But what I'm hoping is they'll get used to this wire, and I can just run some wire around top of it, and they see it and they stay out. But I may have to go through there and run some. It's just going to be hard because I don't have T-posts. So I don't know. We'll see what we're going to do. And what I'm going to do to be tying this wire off today is I've got some water hose here, and we're going to start over over here on this corner. Now, I did run out of these T-post wrapped rounders, insulators. So Steph went to Tractor Supply to get me a few more bags of these. And I told her to go ahead and get one more roll of this. Just that way we have enough to go ahead and finish it off. But I'm gonna go ahead and open this. And what this is going to do is it's going to insulate it, keep it from shorting out. And then we're going to take it and wrap it around here. As long as I got an insulator on that, it's going to be perfectly fine. What we're going to do is come in here and actually pull some more of this string out. Might have got too much, but... Once Steph gets here, it'll be a lot easier. It's amazing how much harder it is when part of the family's gone or they're sick. Because I'm going to tell you, Leighton is a big help around this farm, which, you know, he got sick while we was gone, but he was still able to take care of the farm and, you know, do what we asked. So... we're very pleased with him. So back there at that gate there, I'm going to run it straight through. We can lean down and go through. But I actually think we're going to put the charger right here on this side. Put it here. And then these things here, I will bring over here with a gate. Switch deal. Let me show you. I had and got two of these here, but I think I'm going to go ahead and tie them off, and then we'll loop it right there where it'll come across, stretch, and then it will be hot. This is what will make it hot. But once we open it, release this from here, it will no longer be hot. So I think that's what we're going to do on this part here. Don't know how I'm going to tie these yet, so I'm just going to put them right here and wait until I get the other end. Now we got all that, we're going to go back down there and we're going to start over again, and then hopefully by then Steph will be home when we put the rest of the insulators on and she can help me pull the rest of it, and that should be a wrap and we may be able to make all this hot tonight. Looky there, guys. There's that beautiful woman. I'm going to make that gate a lot better so they don't have to park on the roadway. I'm gonna have to get some pipe and bring it in, but I wasn't gonna do it until we actually got our house built. But I think we're gonna have to do it sooner than later just because that's going to cause an accident. Somebody not paying attention top that hill, because they fly really fast down that road. See, I mean, right there she is, this park. All right, let's see how the practice went. And like I say, guys, I'm gonna ask Stephanie about Leighton. That way she can tell you everything about it. Huh?
You asked me if I got gas.
The gas for the lawnmower.
Are they in the back?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, you did it. Listen at her. So what was the results on Leighton?
They didn't seem too confident, but they were saying pretty much they think that it is just a stomach bug. All his white blood cells and everything was good, but he does have super high liver enzymes, so they want us to do a follow-up with the pediatrician.
So I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to connect this here to this to make that hot. So what I've thought about, and I went back to watch some videos, but I don't have the connector. So what I thought about is cutting a little hole right here. Y'all let me know if this will work. If not, I'll come back. Ooh. and change it. We're going to pull it up about like that. And I'm going to take a knot here. I'm going to put it in there just like that. Then I'm going to come up here. Remember like how last year we had a lot of tie knots? I'm going to try to keep from doing that. Got that tied there.
Got to duck a little bit.
Can't do it. I'm gonna try to do a different one. I'm gonna let you do this one.
Okay.
He's gonna let you.
Yeah. I'll tell you about that boy right there. He's been on the road. I'll take this one.
I was trying to do that way because make it easier.
No. There's only one way you can do it. Take it and pull it. Pull it to you. Oh, you're gonna push in. Push. All right, I push.
Like this?
Yep, just like that. You're done.
Like that?
Mm-hmm.
I keep it like that. Definitely.
Mother. Get underneath this right here, though, babe.
What?
See this bump right here? These bumps, you have to get in between it. So bring it back this way. Start right here, and you'll go in between.
What?
You have it upside down?
Remember right there?
Yeah.
Now pull it. Pull it this way. There you go. Keep on. We're going to have about 3 clicks.
Like this.
1, 2. One more click.
Okay. I'm not trapping.
I know. I said, Bub, you going with me to the ball field? Addison has practice. Or are you staying with Dad? He said, no, I'm staying at. I gotta get what's getting my chickens. I was like, okay. I was very surprised. Oh, yeah.
This collie girl. This a collie girl.
We making you something.
Yeah, we making you something, sister.
You know, Don't cross this.
I know, even though it's a gate, so that we can actually touch this and pull it, I'm still going to probably turn it off every time.
Yeah, you can. But what I'm saying, the reason why I'm doing this here is, like, you can still open these, and it's still hot back there. If for some reason, you need it hot. Right there.
You want it really low.
So this here, you can actually put it on a T-post here. It's got the grooves here, so whatever size T-post you have. Hit it down there a little bit, and this here slides in right here. Then you put this dude right here, and you adjust it to whichever direction your sun is coming from. All right, so last time we just put some wire to it and did this, but we're going to try to do everything right this time so it works perfect.
have a feeling these two are troublemakers. What are you two doing? That's Skittles' little baby girl, or that's Skittles' little baby boy, and that white and black and brown goat also.
But me and Dad catch something perfectly, right, Dad?
Mm-hmm.
We catch something in my trap.
Yeah.
Definitely. You know, raccoons like to eat crackers?
Mm-hmm. They do.
Huh?
They do?
They do?
I don't know. Do?
I don't
know. I bet they like them animal crackers.
Oh, yeah.
That's probably where they got their name, animal crackers, huh?
That's what happened to me. Is it right now?
Yeah. Oh, is it?
Uh-huh.
Oh, boy.
Because something stole it.
Oh, you going to light them up, light them up, light them up. Light them up. All right, guys. Here we go.
Touch it.
Okay, I will.
No.
Hold on.
No. Shh. I do that thing.
Oh, ho, ho.
Hey, Dad.
You can't see it on the camera, can you?
Yeah, you could. I just seen it.
Oh, okay, okay.
Hey, Dad.
What, baby?
I touched it. You have to come behind the dog.
No, I don't play that game. It's live, boys and girls. It's live.
7,000 volts.
All right. So let's turn this off and let's get the goats in. So here's the deal, Kayson. Listen to me. If you touch this, it's going to electrocute you, okay? And it's going to hurt very, very bad.
Hey, you did it!
Walk that way. Keep going. One more. Push. Good girl. Go.
Good job.
Yeah, but she came back out. But we can put her back in. It'll be fine. She's in there. Yeah, the yellow is what electrocutes. Carly would be the first one to get it.
I thought the gray stuff is connected to it, too. Can I can touch the gray stuff, right? Just not the yellow. Big. Gold.
Yeah, he won't do it again, but he's probably never seen electric fence.
All right, guys, so we finally got it up, and it is working. As you seen, Badger got hit, and the dogs have already jumped up there and got hit as well. So
they thought they were getting out.
They thought they was going to get out, but I will say that this electric fence should help and keep all the animals inside, because once they see that wire, they'll never come up to it, because they'll always think it's on. So eventually I'll probably have to run some on the backside, but for now that'll work. But we want to thank each and every one of y'all for watching. If you're new to the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. Hope you have a wonderful night. God bless.